Hello.
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman. Rise and shine. Not that I wish to imply you have been sleeping on the job. No one is more deserving of a rest, and all the effort in the world would have gone to waste until...
That's creepy lips.
Well, let's just say your hour has come again. The right man in the wrong place can make all the difference in the world. So wake up, Mr. Freeman. Wake up and smell the ashes.
I'm awake. Oh, can I just say, he looks, the way he pronounces these things, it's almost like he's trying to sell me on some kind of new form of birth control.
And so you get on.
But hello, everybody, and welcome to a new Let's Play of Let's Play Cinematic Fake Factory Mod 2013.
No matter how many times I've been relocated, I never get used to it.
Yeah, I feel you, buddy. I feel you. I'm on this train, too. So, you may be asking, why am I playing Cinematic Fake Factory Mod when I could be playing Normal Half-Life 2? Well, or maybe you don't even know what Cinematic Fake Factory Mod is. Well, and if you're one of those people, well...
End of the line.
I'm here to introduce you to a graphical overhaul of Half-Life 2. A lot of people don't like this mod for a lot of good reasons, a lot of bad reasons. But I, on the other hand, think it looks pretty nice, and since it has basically been half of my life since Half-Life 2 came out, I figured I would do a Let's Play of Half-Life 2 with the Cinematic Fake Factory mod for no reason other than lens flares! Look at that! And so, J.J. Abrams took over Half-Life. This is the result. But yeah, we're going to get through this series. It's going to be pretty awesome. Just going to be playing through Half-Life 2 with some new... Oh, shit. What are you doing, man? I can't throw bottles in the streets anymore. What the hell? I'm just going to not look at you. I'm going to sneak my way over here. But yeah, I'm not sure how long this series will go for. I mean, it's going to be like... couple hours. I'm trying to remember how long Half-Life 2 is, but it's a longer game. But we're gonna get through it and with some insights. I'm pretty knowledgeable on Half-Life. If you haven't seen my other videos,
don't drink the water. They put something in it to make you forget.
Like what?
I don't even remember how I got here.
He got freaking date raped already. I mean, I hate to spill it to you, man, but if you don't remember what happened, and you just drank something, I mean, I have a few people that I need to introduce you to, such as the police. Maybe you should be telling the cops.
Or maybe they're the ones who are doing it. Oh, OMG, the twists. The turns.
It's like a Twizzler. If a game was a Twizzler, I would be a happy man. I don't even know what that means. Ow! You should not throw large sacks at men. They get uncomfortable. Look at it. It's Nova Prospect. Let's go on the train. I'm ready. Hey. Not letting me on the train. What did I do? Did I smell funny? Alright, alright. I'll follow you into creepy hallway. Looks very nice, though. I mean, take a look at that. That is really nice looking.
Standard relocation coupon, just like everybody else.
Slamming doors in my face, slamming things in my face. I mean, come on. Yeah, at the very least, you know, a lot of people get this mod hate because of the models in it. As you can see, I've reverted the models to the standard Half-Life 2 models. But other than that, the level design, like the graphics, shaders, I think they're great. Everyone else can eat a big bucket of my. Not giving a fuck. Privacy. Oh, very professional. I'm getting
about
a phone.
That
call.
Beer
it's
owed.
Barney Calhoun.
It's me, Barney from Black Mesa. Hey, sorry for the
call.
Scare. I had to put on a show for the cameras.
Yeah.
I've been working undercover with civil protection. I can't take too long or they'll get suspicious. I'm way behind on my beating quota.
I always thought that was funny that they have a beating quota. It's like six people
I'm in the
a day.
Middle of a critical test.
I would hope
sorry,
for 10.
Doc, but look who's here. Great Scott.
Gordon Freeman. It's me.
Expected more warning.
Yeah,
you
on the
and
train this
both,
whole time.
Doc.
It's creepy
he was
lips.
About to board the express to Nova Prospect.
Well, Barney, what do you intend?
I'm thinking. Alex is around here somewhere. She would have a better idea.
Yes, Alex.
Well, as long as he stays away from checkpoints, we should be okay. Listen, I gotta go, Doc. We're taking enough chances as it is.
Very well. And, Gordon, good to see you.
At least someone's
okay,
good to
Gordon,
see me.
Okay, Gordon, you're gonna have to make your own way to Dr. Kleiner's lab. Oh, man, that's what
Shit.
I was afraid
Shit.
Of.
Get in here, Gordon. They're coming!
Before you blow my cover.
I'm not gonna blow your cover. Get off my back.
To get through that window and keep going till you're in the plaza. I'll meet up with you later.
Maybe there's something on my key. It's like something gritty on my key. You may be, or you might not be wondering, but maybe happy that there's no face cam in this. I know I have an ugly face. Just kidding. I have a beautiful face. There's no real point, purpose in this kind of video for me to do it. I was feeling lazy. If you do want to see a face cam for some reason, let me know. I don't know. I look like crapola. I got off work. I'm in a beanie. Good God. No one wants to see it. Now, as you can see as we enter this room, very beautiful room, but we also have one of the great seven wonders in the world, the Leaning Tower of Shelf. It's dirty, and there's no tourists taking pictures, but that's because of the idiot combine of instated rule upon the land. And that's why we're here. So we're going to take them out. Nice maps. Weirdness. Ooh. Thank you. God, you're a douche. Of course, what does your girlfriend say about you? Nice Coke can. I feel like, is that trademarked? Fake factory. Alright, I was submissive. I submit. I only just saw the 50 Shades Darker, so I'm in a submissive mood. I will put soda in trash for you, Overlord. Thank you. Please, Leaning Tower of Shelf followed me. But we got our friend, what is this? Jack Daniels whiskey. Hey, man, I didn't even hit you. Calm down. Just let me throw my bottles around. Is that going to piss you off, too? You just don't like the noise? Bitch, get used to it. I'm sorry, that was snotty. This is where they get their food, the citizens. Can you imagine living in a world like this? Being watched by like some dystopian... Well, I guess we're heading that way at this point. Is that too early to say? I don't know. Maybe we're heading towards something like this. That would be... Fucking nuts! Look at that! The plaza! Hey, bird. It's so pretty. It also requires planning. Very pretty. Say what you will about the game. I really think it's a nice look. I mean, obviously, of course, some things are different. Maybe some things aren't how they should. Like, for instance, later on in the game, once we get to that point, I'll talk about a few things involving the environment. But, you know, in regards to most things, come on. I mean, the one thing you can say about the game is that it was made by a pretty creepy guy. I mean, look at this. I'm the sperm that won. I mean, that's funny. You know what? I'm not even mad about it. I'm pissed off. Me too. I'm agreeing with him so far. I'm pretty pissed about things. I get pissed every time I freaking walk into a McDonald's. Man, every time I go into a McDonald's now, they fuck my order up in some way, shape, or form. I want one Big Mac, and I get two chickens. Chicken Sammies. What's up with that? That's such BS. How hard is it to do? Why do you duplicate my order and switch to a whole different kind of meat? I was talking cow there. And somehow you got it in your head that I wanted chicken burgers. Two of them. I only wanted one cow burger. No, there will be no meat switching in my dystopian future if I ever run a world like this. I will make sure that everybody knows I want me a cow burger. Stop it. Get back to your post. No one likes you, except for, maybe some of the people who hired you. I don't know, they must have hired you for a reason, or you lied well. Or some on your resume. Starts.
First the building, then the whole block.
Oh, yeah.
They have no reason to come to our place. Don't worry, they'll find one.
Yeah, they're doing raids. Hey, don't take a picture of me. Don't take a picture of me! Don't take a picture of me! I'm talking out of you! I don't want you. I don't like this guy. He's following me. I'm feeling violated. Ah, I blocked it with the box, sucker. What you gonna do about that? So yeah, the Combine are conducting raids in the area. I guess they're trying to find drugs, refugees, people who just stepped off a train from Creepy Lips. I was sent here by the creepy man with lips. Do you know him? I guess most people have lips, but this guy has extraordinarily creepy ones. Okay, I didn't mean to egg you on, man. Gosh, these guys are sensitive. You gonna follow me? You really gonna follow me up here? And it smells funny. Even through your respirator, you can smell this shit. Go back to your post. I used to love doing this when I was a kid. I'd put, like, a bunch of crap on this seesaw here, and then, jump off onto it and like send them flying. For some reason I thought that was really cool. Back then, Half-Life 2, there's a reason why Half-Life 2 was so revolutionary. And it's because of the physics engine. No games really had physics engines back then. There might have been one that I've not heard of, but this is one of the first games that had a physics engine, so it was really cool being able to do stuff like this. I thought that was the shit when I was a kid. I still do. It's freaking awesome. That's legit. One more time for old time's sake. I'm throwing it back, man. It's been a long time since I first played Half-Life 2. Like, the grass is going through the box. Somehow I feel like that I should return that box. That it was not designed for that to happen. I thought it was a solid object. So watch this. Huh! 3, 2, brick! Oh, we got some air.
Got like 3 feet of air that time, Napoleon.
That's right. Alright, so we're gonna go into Elizabeth's 1 through 55. Fuck Combine. Fuck Breen. Fuck them all. Yeah, so that's another thing people don't like about this mod is the graffiti. I can understand that. Oh my. It's still there. What is up with all these leaning shelves? Whoever built these shelves, there needs to be a recall. I need to call somebody. What is the number to call for the shelf guy? Who's the shelf guy in this apartment complex? Anybody? Anybody the shelf guy?
Shut up!
Okay. Alright. There's no shelf guy. I'll stop making noise, guys. And I know it's just Friday and everyone's trying to relax. What's going on? Don't mind me. Just stepped off the train 20 minutes ago and I shouldn't be here. I need to stop saying things like that out loud. Nice apartment. I'm liking the whiskey. There's a ton of whiskey. Jack Daniels, man. They made a killing off of the end of the world. You must really know how to market in a post-apocalyptic society. What's up?
Was that you knocking? I didn't even know we still had a door.
Oh, Lord. Dude, enough with the Jack. You know what? Give me that. Give me that Jack Dude! He's not letting go! Look! I'm trying to pry it off with the chair, and he's not letting me have the Jack Daniels. Okay. Let me check something real quick. Just checking the audio. Make sure that it's a high enough level for you guys. What the fuck? Come on now. Don't do this to me. Okay, it's on high. Let me turn it up just teeny teens. Music volume's low. Why is that? Sorry I'm doing this right now, but just, had to make sure. You know, oh, what the heck is going on? Steam VR just launched. Man. Whatever. I'm gonna ignore it. They changed the soundtrack, too. That's another weird thing, but ignore that. No brain, no! Oh, gosh. Oh, I hope they don't see me. I love how he just stopped and, like, kept going. Flying TV out the window. Oh no, nothing.
Told you they'd be coming for us next.
Take that. Sorry, I just ruined your apartment to prove a point, but like, this is a protest. Stop invading our homes. I mean, this apartment sucks. Imagine coming home to this every day.
No more.
Life's already hard enough. My knees are hurting. I'm only 21. Alright. But apparently I can still dodge a stupid combine. Quit giving me the hand. Like I'm Kesha. Or like you're Kesha. I want to be Kesha. Man, we gotta get out of here. Yeah. They're gonna come for us. This part always scared me as a kid, but I'm pretty sure there's like pretty much no way for them to get you unless you royal, like you just be a complete moron. Watch, let's see if I can. Oh, no, no. Okay, he's coming. Maybe I'm a complete moron. Maybe we're about to find out that I'm a complete moron. Maybe if you need more proof of evidence of that, you need to watch some of my other videos. I might prove it to you. Oh, crap. Don't follow. Stop following me.
Get in here quick.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man. That guy really sacrificed himself for me. For some reason. He's just like, get going. Maybe he's had nothing to live for. If I had nothing to live for, would I help some random stranger who was fleeing the dystopian government? That is one weird thing that I've noticed. Sometimes now when I launch Half-Life 2, my Steam VR launches. It's like, I don't even have my Vive sensors plugged in. And, why are you launching Steam VR? Okay, I'm not gonna ask questions. You want me to play this in VR? This would be awesome. I would be down. Hey, quit taking pictures of me. Oh my gosh, hopefully that's not too loud for you guys. Let me know if the audio's alright below in the comments. Oh my gosh, they're coming for me. Look at that cityscape though, that's pretty dope. Okay, okay, okay. Enough of the Dark Knight music. Jump the thing. Jump the thing, gotta jump the thing. Avoid the pigeons. Pigeons! Get out of my face and pictures! Pictures and gunshots are missing. Oh my god, it's like Instagram every other day. Ow! I got shot. That's how Instagram should be. What? I don't know what that means. Let's make Instagram great again. Hey! We made it. We need to take it easier for a second. Danger. Confined space. Hazardous atmosphere. Air supplied respirator required for entry. I'm not going that way. Not that I can. Take that! Now let that be a message to your dystopian government. Oh! Dang, fell down some stairs, and we're gonna get beat up. I am ready. I deserve this. Beat me! Don't beat me! Alright, beat me. Ow! Who could that be? Is it? Is it who I think it is? Is it who you think it is? Oh my god!
Dr. Freeman, I presume.
It's her!
We better hurry. The Combine can be slow to wake, but once they're up, you don't want to get in their way.
Man, she beat freaking like six Combines, I asses. That's...
Dr. Kleiner said
marry
you
me.
This way. I don't think it occurred to him that you might not have a map.
Very funny, very funny. Wow.
I'm Alex Vance. My father worked with you back in Black Mesa.
I recall.
I'm sure you don't remember me, though.
I recall. You were a baby when I last saw you.
Man, a few words, aren't you?
I just said you were a baby. But now you're a babe, huh? Huh? Will you take this box as my offer of matrimony? It's actually funny. Earlier this year, I married someone for the first time. I had a reverend license sitting around.
Okay, my dad
used.
Started on Dr. Breen.
And I freaking finally had someone came up to me finally and was like, hey, we're getting married. And I had the opportunity to marry them, which is actually pretty cool. I was happy to check that off my list.
In particular.
Yeah. It just did happen like that. I didn't plan it. The guy with the creepy mouth gave me this opportunity. Look at that lens photo. That's ridiculous.
We've been helping people.
Little much, Cinematic Fake Factory.
It's a dangerous route to my father's lab. Through the old canals. Today, we're finally on the verge of having a better way.
Goes to show the power you can still beef into the source engine if you really, push it. I mean, it looks good. I would buy this for $20, and I wouldn't bat an eye at the graphics.
Nice to finally meet you.
It's nice to meet you, Alex. I'll meet you inside. You can freshen up. I'll see you in. Hello! Dr. Kleiner's lab! Look at that. We got wires up the wazoo.
Lamar, come out of
there?
He's not in there. Did you check your wazoo?
Oh, hello, Alex. Well, almost all right. Lamar has gotten out of her crate again.
Damn, head bumper. Where is
I
it?
I suspect Barney of trapping and... My goodness. Gordon Freeman. It really is you, isn't it?
Well, he just doesn't see me.
Bit of a troublemaker, isn't he?
We owe a great deal to Dr. Freeman, even if trouble does tend to follow in his wake.
Wow, what's that supposed to mean, asshole?
I must stutter. You come at a very opportune time. Alex has just installed the final piece for our resurrected teleport.
F. Kleiner, what is that background?
Nonsense. Your talents surpass your loveliness.
Let's just see if this thing works, okay?
Flirty flirt. And it's Barney.
Man, Gordon, you stirred up the hive.
That's right. I like honey. Hey, honey. I love this plant that you can teleport around. Nice. You can teleport anything you want.
We'll inaugurate the new teleport.
You're talking about teleportation crap. We're gonna get teleported. Hi, Einstein.
Because I still have nightmares about that cat.
No.
That
cat.
To be
nervous.
I'm gonna teleport
about.
Your coke.
We've made major strides.
Wonder if it's gonna radiate it. Let's radiate his coke and give it to him. Oh, whoops. Send. Receive. Okay, let's try it again. Oh, I'm throwing a binder in there. Haha. Boom! Got you a nice radiated Coca-Cola. I'm not, oh my god, no, I poured it all over the computer with your creepy, I don't know, maybe that's not creepy. It looks like some old-time movie star on your wallpaper, but I'm gonna pretend like you, oh my god.
I thought you got rid of that pest.
Damn it,
certainly
Lamar.
Not. Never fear, Gordon. She's de-beaked and completely harmless. The worst she might do is attempt to couple with your head.
Oh my gosh.
Get that thing away from me!
Here, my pet. Hop up.
Hop up onto his head.
No, not up there! No! No! Careful, Lamar. Those are quite fragile.
Knock the computer! There you go.
Oh, fie. It'll be another week before I can coax her out of there.
Yeah, you need something to do in here, you goofball. What do you do for fun?
You're not an animal person.
Might as well coax a headcrab out of a vent. Sounds like an Olympic sport that I'd watch. This week! Who wins the gold in head crab venting? I would honestly probably watch that more than curling. Not that I hate, not I'm hating on curlers.
The AGV suit still fits you like a glove. At least the glove parts do. I've made a
great
few
lines
modifications,
today, Kleiner.
But I'll just acquaint you with the essentials. Now let's see.
Boom! His head bobbing. When you're running and fake fat. Oh, this makes me sick.
Environment suit has been redesigned for comfort and utility.
I can watch 3D movies and not get sick.
Oh,
yeah, the combines are onto us. Horns. They know what building we're in. Good God. We're really being a little sketchy here.
I've modified your suit. Combine energy outlets.
Institute of Tech. Bachelor of Science and Experimental Physics.
Meanwhile,
what the
let's get this show.
He's a doctor, isn't he? Oh, the hell. Isaac Kleiner, the degree of Bachelor of Science? Whoa!
Well, let's get this show on the road.
Sorry, guys. I don't know why, but my Steam VR just crashed the mod. I don't know why, but I need to figure that out once I and stop the recording on this video. What the heck is going on with it? It's just confusing me. But it's alright. We're back! And about to be ported. Port me, doctor! It sounds a little... Alright, I'm not gonna say it like that again. It sounds a little sexual, like I want something. But I don't!
And wait for my word.
It's Eli.
Yes,
Eli,
yes, Eli. Bit of a hold up on this end.
It's kind of awkward. I'm like meeting the girlfriend's father. Suddenly, it's like our first day together. Hey! Oh, it's me.
Indeed, it is.
I'm her boyfriend. I mean, I'm not. She doesn't know that yet. I mean, what?
In the company of your lovely daughter.
Are you ready for us, Dad?
We're all set on this end.
Then let's do it.
Let's do it. Okay. Jesus. Can you believe someone like Kleiner built this? I cannot imagine setting something like this up. I can barely fucking make a sandwich for lunch. The night before work. Wire. Just plug the wire back in and it fixes everything. He thinks we're a genius. I'm going to pull this lever because I'm MIT qualified as Dr. Gordon Freeman. You only have a Bachelor of Science, apparently, Kleiner. Pathetic. Quite pathetic, actually. Dude, that looks scary as F. I don't want to do that. She started screaming.
Well, did it work?
Speak for yourself.
Hey, Doc.
What up?
Thank goodness. My relief is almost palpable.
Fantastic. This is interesting words.
Well, I can't take all the credit. Dr. Freeman proved an able
assistant. Yeah.
Let's go ahead and bring Gordon through now.
Right you are. Speak to you again in a few moments.
Good job, Gordon. Throwing that switch and all. I can see your MIT education really pays for itself.
Alright, Barney. Your turn.
Very funny. Yeah, it's like I got all this credit from Kleiner. He's like sucking up. Meanwhile, it's like the easiest thing ever. All I do is pull one lever and plug in a wire. Kleiner's a nice guy. He's a nice guy. Alright. Let's make this happen.
Barney, if you'd be so kind.
Good luck out there, Gordon.
Yes, indeed.
Bye,
we're
Barney.
Ready to project you, Gordon.
I loved your purple dinosaur alter ego.
Good luck in your future endeavors. Final sequence.
Oh, it's really... I wonder what I would just put my arm in there. Oh, my God. It's Lamar. Stop it. What the F? Knocked a beam into it. That was it. Where's Lamar? Let me out of here. Whoa. Let me... Okay, I like this. Never mind. Breen, no! I'm not here. I love how all the places in the world teleported me into Breen's office for the lol. Just lol. Oh. Oh, God damn, no. This is the worst trip ever. It's like I just... What'd you give me? Some shrooms or something? What is happening?
Shut it down.
Gordon, you must get out of here. Run. Get down out of sight. I'll come find you.
Okay. I'm tripping, all right? Give me a break. Whoa. Holy macaroni. Macaroni. No, they know where I am now. Hey, combine scanners. You get a life. Wait, you're robots. You have no life. Ha 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 ha. Go film a porno or something. I mean, you got a nice camera. I mean, that's what I would do if I was a robot that had nothing else to do. I'd let my services be acquired for.
Hey, Gordon.
You know. Oh, hey, what's up? I wasn't talking to myself about anything
weird.
I've
never seen it lit up like that. Get out of City 17 as fast as you can, Gordon. Take the old canals, right? They'll get you to Eli's lab. It's a dangerous route, but there's a whole network of refugees, and they'll help you if they can. I'd come with you, but I gotta look after Dr. Kleiner. Oh, and
he needs
before
it.
I forget, I think you dropped this back in Black Mesa.
Yeah, the crowbar.
There, you're gonna need it.
Now, I personally like the animations of this crowbar better than the one in Half-Life 2. I like how you kind of carry the crowbar up a bit higher. It's kind of more angled. Got more. It feels more like Half-Life 1's animations. If that makes sense. I mean, in Half-Life 1, you were like, wop, 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 wop. Like, it was... You were swinging that thing around like it was made of straw. You know, just beating people's asses with the crowbar. Like, boom, 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 boom. This one's like, has some weight to it, and I like it. It's cool. Nope, not this time. I mean, you got the picture, but, like, I got your hard drive in pieces. Thanks for nothing. Jack Daniels! I'm taking it with me. Dang it! Ah, I can't pick up bottles. I'm just with me and not be... Oh, no! Ran over by trains and not being able to pick up bottles. I'm running fast. Just call me running. Usain Bolt. But maybe Insane Bolt. I mean, getting shot. Let me get this cover here. I'm flustered. Okay, we made it. Dark tunnel. Oh, dirty sewers are my favorite sewers. I don't like those clean ones, personally. Oh, what the man beater? What the? Don't beat men, idiot! Take it in the face.
You'd better run. There's nothing else you can do here.
Man, he got knocked out just from one little punch. I mean, maybe he got beaten up beforehand. I don't want to presume he's a pussy. I don't even think I would be able to take it. If I got smacked in the face like that, I would probably explode. Stop! Drop and die. Okay, or not. I'll shoot you in the face. You ask for it. And I'm going to take... I know there's one guy around this corner, so watch this. Whoa! Oh, like a doctor in the night, less than half a second. And what the crap? He's like glitching out. Look. Oh my gosh. It's like the Idiots of Gary's Mod. Without even trying. Amazing. Man, the whole city's on alert. I better jerk off real quick. What? Just kidding. Maybe I'm not kidding. I don't know. Or am I? Either way, I think this is about as good a spot to end it for the first episode as any. Hope you guys are interested in this. If you guys are, let me know by leaving a like, comment, or subscribe. All that BS, you know what the deal is. I love you guys, and I have some more videos coming, so next time on Let's Play Cinematic Fig Factory Mod, or Half-Life 2, we go into the Underground Railroad, which is the next segment of Half-Life 2, which is going through the Root Canal section. It's going to be pretty dope. Sue us for days. All right, see you guys.